title. Copenhagen, we look forward to joining you in 2021.
To the center, just the center of it all, right? Right
yeah.
here?
Yeah!
And then we protest that we made it here. So that's how we are. We are fierce. Oh, because we are everybody, that's for sure. Here's a song 25 years ago, I hope. Became a big part of my life. Our life together, bring us here. Join with me, please. Come on. I'll dial the numbers just to listen to your breath. I would stand inside my hell and hold the hand of death. You don't know how far I go to ease this precious ache. And you don't know how much I give or how much I can take. Just to reach you, just to reach you, oh, to reach you, oh, come to my window, crawl inside, wait by the light of the moon, come to my window, I'll be home soon, song. Well, you've been around the world, and I'm very proud of that. It's a song about the angst of love, oh my goodness. Oh, and how we burn for it. We are on fire, are we not? Yeah. Is it so hard to satisfy your senses? You find out to love me. You have to climb some fences, scratching and crawling along the floor to touch you. And baby, just when it feels right, you say you found someone to hold. Does she like I do, baby? Tell me, does she love you like the way I love you? Does she stimulate you, attract and captivate you? Tell me, does she miss you, existing just to kiss you? Like the way I feel, cry my face.
We put all the lesbians first because they have to leave because they have to go home and let the dogs out. We're going to keep it moving. I wish you happy World Pride! Yeah! Incredible. Well, this is incredible. And now, you know, this is so amazing that we're here. And I think that, you know, like, we just can't take this for granted, you know? I send love out to all the gay people all over the world, all the LGBTQIA, everybody out there, especially to Istanbul. Girl, they tried to have pride in Istanbul, girl. They tried it, honey. And I'm like, so, like, maybe one day we'll be able to have this celebration in Istanbul, just like it is here. Yeah, we're gonna have an amazing, amazing day. Oh, look, I can't, can you see my fupa? I can't, I'm trying to look at my fupa. Yeah, okay. See, look, now this. Look at my, I've never seen my twerking before. It's kind of a different perspective. Oh. See, this is all, I thought it was gonna go up in my vagina, but I guess it's not too bad. It's not too bad. Sorry, the gay men are like, bitch, pussy already? You just got up here.
Girl!
Girl!
No, girl!
It's a gay word. It means everything. It's not, it doesn't just mean girl. It's like every word. It's like aloha or shalom. It means everything. Girl! Gay pride is difficult. There's a lot of steps, you know, because first May, which is hard work, because May is like gay Ramadan, where all gay people all over the world fast so we can have a snatched body for pride. Honey, I can't wait for July when I can eat again, seriously. I'm not putting on anything skin tight until the next pride, next world pride. But it's very, I mean, you know, you gotta represent, it's a whole thing. So the gay summer goes on. We're going to Provincetown after this. Provincetown, very exciting to go to Provincetown. I really love Provincetown. To me, it's the gay resort. It's hard to get there. You have to take a tiny plane. The plane is so small, you have to tell the pilot how much you weigh. So I'm on a tiny plane with seven bears. We've all lied about our weight. Just looking at each other like, bitch, we're going down. I'm mostly a bear hag. I'm mostly a bear hag. I love bears because you know you're going to eat. With Twinks, meals are unscheduled. You just don't know. You don't know. They're always intermittent fasting or doing those white drugs with the Twinks. I love a Twink too. It's just hard because Twinks my age, Twinks that are 50 and over have it rough. They're all getting a plastic surgery, which never helps them look younger. It just results in permanent gay face. Just queer in the headlights. I love bears. I if I was a gay man, I would be a bear. That's it. I would be a panda bear. I'm Ling Ling. Panda bear. Bears, I'm attracted to bears. That's what I find sexy. I love a bear, you know, always smiling, swiping at cock like it's salmon from a frosty mountain stream. That's how you know you're in a gay neighborhood is you start hearing the girl. Either that or,
do you believe in life?
I think it's like, you know, like, for me, like, gay life is really, like, Provincetown, we will meet there again in the summer, and it's going to be exciting. I actually have a little beach house in Provincetown that I had to have soundproofed, because there was so much, girl, 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 all around, because there's brunches served round the clock around my house. That's how you know you're around gay people, is brunches being served, girl, girl. I had to have it soundproof because it was just like all day, all night. It was like cicadas. Or cicadas. It's an old gay. The old gay is like, I can understand. I have a lot of young gay friends who are so gay, I can't understand what they're talking about. They're like, work, I'm a slay. Yes, he. Yes. My youngest gay friend is Jonathan Van Ness from Queer Eye. The long, beautiful hair. He's actually too famous now to do my hair. He was my hairdresser, so that's why my hair's all fucked up. I know, I'm sorry. He's such a love, but sometimes he's so gay, I don't understand. Like, he went on this Grindr date, which, by the way, I love Grindr. I love Grindr. There's no lesbian equivalent to Grindr. The closest thing we have is Animal Rescue. So, Jonathan went on a Grindr date with this hot top who didn't talk the whole date, didn't speak. So Jonathan went home with a top, and the top was fucking Jonathan up the ass. And when the top came, he went, that made me homophobic. I was like, that was actually too gay. That's the sound of a top. I thought it would be familiar to some of you bottoms here. Like, I know you speak top, don't you? Just bottoms. Oh my God, my ass is escaping. Look, it's coming out of the side. It's like, it's kind of flat, eh? Look at, oh, I like with the pride flag behind it. It makes it seem really good. It's like an old man's ass, actually. It's like an old leather daddy's ass. It's like real Folsom Street Fair. Very San Francisco. I have a flat ass. Asian people always have a flat ass because we're always sitting and studying. Yeah. Take that, Lori Loughlin. Shade, Lori Loughlin. He put the shade on Lori Loughlin. Girl. Okay, so I'm here with you all night. It's gonna be amazing. Well, we have Deborah Cox, we have M-N-E-K, we have Jake Shears, we have Mel C, and then it's like, we have the prom. There's so much that's gonna happen. I will be here holding your hand for the whole time.
And now I want to welcome to the stage someone that needs little introduction, someone that has been so supportive of our plans from the very start. Please welcome New York City Mayor Bill de Blasio.
Happy Pride!
Yeah!
I can't hear you, Happy Pride!
Yeah!
Has this been an amazing celebration?
Yeah!
30 days, this whole month, 30 days of joy, 30 days of love, 30 days of pride that apologizes to no one.
Yeah!
Everybody here tonight helped to make history, the first World Pride in the United States ever.
Yeah!
And I need your help to thank everyone who made it possible, the organizers, the volunteers, the sponsors, all the first responders, the men and women in uniform who stood by and helped protect us. You are in the Big Apple, but this place is also proud to be, and I am proud to be the mayor of the city with the largest LGBT community in the United States of America, and we are proud every day. We are proud to be the city of Stonewall, where the rebellion began, to give people the rights they deserved so long ago. And that spirit of Stonewall, it's not ancient history, is it?
No.
It's something that we have to live today. Because there's more work to do. We are so happy tonight and we are proud tonight, but we have more to do, brothers and sisters, don't we?
Yeah.
We celebrate love. We reject hate. But we have to be resolved that no one is going to turn back the hands of time and take away our rights. For a long time, it felt like our nation was just moving forward. More respect, more inclusion. We were becoming a better community for everyone. But in recent years, we've seen a lot more bigotry, haven't we?
Yes.
In recent years, we've seen hatred start to take hold again.
Yes.
Is that the America you believe in?
No!
Do you believe we can do better than that?
Yes!
We have seen hate crimes come back. And we won't stand for it. We have seen the right to health care for members of the LGBT community taken away, and we won't stand for it. We have seen trans Americans who want to serve their nation told they can't, and we will not stand for that. Everyone's got to get involved. Everybody here, everyone you know, we have to be involved to right these wrongs. Because a day is coming soon, and I believe that day will be in 2021. where we can turn the clock right back in the forward direction, where we can embrace the entire LGBT community, where we can tell trans people, we respect you, we need you, we want you in our armed services, and we honor you for being willing to serve.
Yes.
And we can tell our veterans, brothers and sisters, our veterans who were thrown out of the military because of who they were and who they loved, they still deserve that honorable discharge. They still deserve the respect of their nation. They still deserve the benefits of all those who served. And we have to fix that too, and we can fix it. So I have a question as we look past World Pride to all we have to do ahead. Do you feel strong tonight?
Yeah!
Do you feel powerful tonight?
Yeah!
Do you feel like you're ready to make a change tonight?
Yes!
We need to fight for each other. We need to fight for a society that truly loves and embraces all. I hope in these last days you have felt the love and you have felt the possibility. World Pride is not just a celebration, it's an example of the world that we should live in, the world we can all create together. But the authors of that better world are every single one of you. So feel pride and feel power. God bless you all.
I'm obsessed with this next performer. I think, look, I identify? I am bisexual. So, yes, I am the B in the LGBT. The B is often silent, so you don't hear it. Nobody cares about the bisexual community. It's just me and Cynthia Nixon. But we're here, we're queer. Yes. We're part of it, honey. And yes, I'm obsessed with this next performer. I think we live close to each other. I think we're neighbors. And oh, hi! I didn't see there was an interpreter. Were you here this whole time and I missed you? I missed you. Oh wait, my ass is still, it's still kind of, is it better this one or this one? I'm not sure. Oh, I'm so excited, you guys. This is the best, this is the best. Please welcome Jake Shears!
Take your the desert don't mind them. New Orleans, Jimmy Temple, man, they make a cut.
Do it, take your
heart
for help, oh now. Just a heart, no doubt, I'm doing all the best we can.
One day today. I am Jake Shears, and this is the Jake Shears Band.
Yeah!
Special to me, at least. I've never put this song out, but I just thought it'd be really fun to play it today. It's really a true thing. It's called "If It Ain't One Thing, It's Another," and we all know that's God's honest truth. Everything's gone southbound. But I found my woman at his truck stop diner, with a stone on her finger looking bigger than China. Bring it on, Jesus, won't you give it to me? My skin is twice as thick, it's just got the right to be. If it ain't one thing, it's another. But he dropped me in the Castro. Got high with a hussy and we had some fun. Then we robbed a bank, now we're on the run. Love don't bring me home yet, still not ready to return. I know heaven's gates wait, I still got hellfire to burn. You can hang me from the gallows, you can drown me in the sea. My skin is twice as thick, it's got any right to be. If it ain't one thing, it's another. If it ain't one thing, it's another. If it ain't one thing, it's another. Words, I still expect the worst. Let me die.
P Spice. I'm actually STD Spice. No, this is so exciting. I love her. She is an icon. Please welcome Melanie C.
Hello, Times Square. Well, I first of all have to make an apology on behalf of the other Spice Girls because they couldn't be here. They'd love to be here, but I brought some other friends along. Would you like to meet them?
Yeah!
Good. I think you're going to like them. So I found Ginger, aka Joan Ohn. And then we have Scary, aka Estella Mandela. And then of course we have the gorgeous Baby. And then, stop the press. Posh decided she could make this performance. Here she is, aka Liffy. So should we get spicy right now?
Yeah!
Let's do it. A privilege to be on this stage. Such an important year for Pride.
Yeah.
Such a big, big celebration. World Pride.
Yeah.
No less.
You gotta love yourself, and I'm still
this moment is so special for me. As a little girl growing up in Toronto, I dreamed of being on the Broadway stage. And to be performing right here in the middle of Times Square, right here where the Palace Theater was, where I made my Broadway debut. And Aida is surreal. I'd like to do this next song from the show. I think it's very telling for this moment that nothing in life is ever easy. And that if you believe in love, love can do many things. This is a moment when God's expect me to beg for help, but I won't even try. I want nothing in the world but myself to protect me, and I won't lay down, roll over and
I love you. All I have to do.
on television in my so-called life.
Hello, my loves. Come on out, y'all. Come on out. I just wanted to say one thing. First of all, I have so much love for all of you. And I just wanted to say that I want you to take all of the love that you have felt here this week, this weekend, and I want you to take it out into the world with you and spread all of it, because this is what the world should look like. And I want you to remember to be proud of yourself. And I want you to remember there was a reason why the people who did the first march 50 years ago chose the word pride. They chose it because we were a people who were made to feel shamed about who we are and who we love. And they wanted to empower you to let that shame go. Because you have only reason to feel pride. We have something for you. I love you.
I love you all. And I'm so excited for our finale. We have 21 amazing performers from all the Broadway shows out there, and they are releasing for you one of the most iconic, important songs ever. Please welcome Broadway!
Minutes, 525,000 moments so deep, 525,600 minutes, how do you measure a year, in daylights, in sunsets, in midnights, in cups of coffee, in inches, in miles, in laughter, in striving. 525,600 minutes, how do you measure a year in the life? How about
into the beat.